All right, so we should be recording now. So in Nevada Box, down in F3 Full, the F3 Demo 2016 Training V6.zip, 6 gigabytes. You want that. Back up in 755. You want as well the DGBES DeGroote Brill Earth Sciences Open Attack Training Manual PDF. That's 82 megabytes. You want to be looking at that because that has the exercises that we're going to go through. And then the challenge now is to get the OD data on your you get the F3 demo training folder after being unzipped into 12 gigabytes under your OD data folder. Now I could should I start up my Windows and see if I can get some further hints about that? Let's give that a shot. Oh joy. I'll record my one-time setup. You know, you guys can talk. You just have to be aware that you know, it may be what you say is being recorded. I don't mind if you guys are asking questions or talking or whatever. Okay. So, you know, if we just open up some random folder, not that you can see anything, let's see if this works. Okay. Yeah, it's not that easy to find your home folder. It's the one that's above your documents folder. And wow.
That's the documents is just the library.
Let's see. Yeah, maybe we have to drill down from the your home folder in it should be above your desktop folder. Oh, wait a minute. There it is. John and Louis, you know, that's my login on this virtual machine. And so when you get to this folder, you'll see a downloads folder. You know, inside it is all this stuff. Your desktop, your downloads are below it, your favorites are below it, your documents are below it, your music. It's all below your home folder. So in there, you should see an OD data folder if you've installed OpenDetect under Windows. So that's where that would be. Okay, so I'll put that on hiatus. I prefer not to run the Windows version of OpenDetect at the moment, because the mouse will get terribly confused. Yes. Okay. just had to be assertive. So once you have the F3 demo 2016 training V6 in the right place in the OD data folder, you should start OpenDetect, and then let's see what you should see. Where did OpenDetect go? Right here. And you're not going to see this right away. Maybe you will. You might see the. You go to survey and select setup to get the survey. So let's do that. You might have it on demo open detect, in which case you. Okay. No, that didn't work. You might have it on the F3 demo start. Okay. Okay, great. Let's see, and I cannot drag this dialogue. Interesting. So when you start OpenDetect, you may get a please select plugins to auto to start up, and I say yeah, show the dialogue at startup and accept all of the plugins. In which case you'll get a complaint. I see. Okay. All right. Well, now my OpenDetect is crashing. Let's see. All right. Yeah. Who knows? I may need to reboot. Let's try opening it in here. Probably running Windows and OpenDetect at the same time was too much. Some hints there. What? It's saying I need to install X11. That can't be right. Oh, boy. All right. Well, clearly, I'm going to have to stop and reboot. Now, I should give you a little more information by let's take a little tour through this manual and show you what I would like to hit eventually. Think about whether you'd like to have another session this Friday at 3. That would be easy enough for me. I know there's a couple of people who are gone each Friday. but hopefully we can get at least one person from each of the three teams at all the sessions. What we're going to do is from the bookmarks here in that 82 megabyte tome is we're going to look at we start at 1.3 basic interaction, and you know there's all these explanations that you can look at in your own time, then there's explanations, and we can and there's these exercises. And anything that says required licenses open detect is just fine. And I might even succeed in getting a license server set up. They're going to give me 15 licenses for the commercial package too. So you're not going to need the commercial package. The added cost package for any of your projects, but if you're interested in exploring what you can do with that, we're going to be able to do that eventually. Each of these objectives has a fairly defined task, and it tries to take you through menu selection by menu selection. To show you how to manipulate the data. So we're going to start with that and just getting some lines, and eventually I want to hoping pretty soon that we can make a random line, which will be a dip line through the data set. To saving and restoring a session, because it takes quite a lot of work to build the elements of your view. Adding each one of these displays, adding each kind of section, takes a bit of setup. So you want to be able to save your view. And you're going to be doing that a lot once you start adding picks and actually making the interpretations. Man, I should have brought a real mouse. Let's see. Okay, and then we're going to start into the seismic interpretation part of this.
No, just make things.
Yeah. So the way I'd like to look at seismic interpretation is really first do the fault interpretation. So we'll go through the 1.4.3a fault plane interpretation first, and this is all illustrated with exactly the same data set that you guys are doing your projects on. Everything is here. The reason for the live sessions is to try to show you what you can do, and more than what you can do, but also try to actively solve problems. So that's kind of where we're going. And you know, if I can't get this working, get OpenDetect working on the display here, we'll have a rather short session. Maybe I can get you guys going separately on your displays, and you know, without illustrating it, if I can't get it to work. All right, I'm getting a screen resolution warning. I can deal with that. It says I need to install X11. That's crazy. I was just running this. Why? Oh, boy. I guess there's no way. Let's see. All right. So, do you guys want to watch me solve my or reinstall OpenDetect? Do you guys want to start doing things on your own machines and just have me come and look and see what you're doing? Yeah.